Hey, good day to you. This is Todd. I am just a regular dude walking in the Word. Thank you for joining us as we are continuing our study through the book of Matthew. We're Jesus is in Jerusalem now in the section of Matthew. You know, he has had the triumphal entry and he's being questioned by religious leaders, okay? And the purpose is to try and trick him up and to so they basically have ammunition against him. But he always really outsmarts them, okay? And so they're trying to do this today by asking about taxes, okay? So this is, I'm entitling it, Should We Pay Taxes? But the issue is not just paying taxes. It was, the issue was trying to trip Jesus up so that they could trap him, but he didn't fall into their trap. And this is taken today from Matthew 22, verses 15 through 22. Okay? So it says this, "Then the Pharisees went out and laid plans to trap him in his words." Here it says it right here. They meant to trap him. "They sent their disciples to him along with the Herodians." Now the Herodians, keep in mind, you had the Sadducees and Pharisees. These were religious leaders. They were religious leaders following a little different avenue of being Jewish, but they just had a little bit different beliefs than each other, but they were united in trying to trip up Jesus, okay? Then you have the Herodians, and you're like, the Herodians, they're not even religious people. They were loyal to Herod, okay? And if you know anything about Herod, Herod was not Jewish, okay? And so they were looking for freedom from Roman oppression through Herod. So this is more of a political thing. So it'd be like today you have the Baptists and the Lutherans, and then they'd be teaming up with the Democrats. And you're like, what? How does that make sense? But they were all trying to be against Jesus. All right. "And so they said, Teacher, they said, we know that you are a man of integrity and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. You aren't swayed by others because you pay no attention to who they are. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it right to pay the imperial tax to Caesar or not? But Jesus, knowing their evil intent, said, you hypocrites, why are you trying to trap me?" I like the way he says it. He calls them hypocrites, you know, right to their face, and says, why are you trying to trap me? He can see right through what they're doing, okay? How would you like to be that person? You're like, I'm trying to trip him up, and he points it out right away. You're trying to trap me. That's the reason you're asking this question. And then he says, show me the coin used for paying the tax. They brought him a denarius, and he asked them, whose image is this, and whose inscription? Caesar's, they replied. Then he said to them, so give back to God, to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's. When they heard this, they were amazed. So they left him and went away. Okay. So I don't have a coin here today. We don't use coins that much. I have a dollar. And so on the dollar is George Washington. And Jesus probably would have said the same thing today. If he was here in the United States, and you have different religious groups that they come along and all of a sudden get the bright idea that we shouldn't pay taxes anymore and support our evil government, which, keep in mind, the Roman government was so much more evil than what we are out to today here in the United States. And so you get these different religious groups, and they come along and go, oh yeah, we should avoid paying taxes. And they do everything they can to get out of paying taxes. Now, I'm in favor of, naturally, because God said it here, Jesus said it, to pay taxes, but I'm not trying to overpay the taxes, okay? So he points it out, and on the picture here is George Washington. And so Jesus would say, well, give to the government their money, and you give to God what's God's, okay? And so that's the key thing here. He says, so give back to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's. Okay. We look at this and we we see that one part there where it says, give to Caesar what is Caesar's. But then we leave out that last part a lot of times where it says, and give to God what is God's. You know, what we do is we go, okay, God said we need to give to Caesar. So we give our taxes away. And then the rest is like, oh, this is all for ourselves. We don't give back to God today. And so that's one thing we've got to work on according to this is you go ahead and pay your taxes. You're supposed to pay your taxes, but then give to God also what's God's. All right. So keep that in mind. Thanks for watching. I'm just a regular dude walking in the Word, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow as we continue our journey through the book of Matthew. Lord's blessing. I'll see you then.